sway just a little bit. There we go.
So you guys hold hands with your left hand or your right hand. And let's shut the door too.
Hi, baby.
Hi.
Grab her
hi,
hand.
Babe.
Hi. I didn't know you were there.
Am I much taller than him?
No.
No,
okay.
Not at all.
Perfect.
All right, who wants to start?
Why?
I'm sorry.
She's crying.
Don't look yet. Nope, you're going to read your vows.
Read your vows.
Oh, we're reading our vows now? Yeah. Not up there?
You're reading them up there.
Go ahead, babe. You start.
Okay. There's a saying that goes, you fall in love with a person in one of three ways, a reason, a season, or a lifetime. I've always looked at that saying from one perspective. True love will only come as once in a lifetime. Because of you, I now look at that saying from a different perspective. Because you are all three, my reason, my season, and my lifetime. You were brought into my life when I needed love the most, hence my reason. You have loved me in every season since we met, even in the roughest moments. And here we stand in front of each other today, vowing to love one another for a lifetime. I love our special connection and how I can give you a simple look, and you know what I'm thinking. You are the person I can always count on to bring me a smile or a shoulder to cry on when I need it. You are my best friend. You never hesitate to help others in need, and that is one of the many reasons why I fell so deeply in love with you. You make me feel safe, protected, and cared for. I can't thank you enough for making me a mother to Olivia and a stepmother to Michael and Isabella. All of my dreams have come true. I promise to keep making all of your dreams come true by loving you with every ounce of my soul until we part this earth. Even then, our love will still linger on because, as we always say, I'll haunt you. Thank you for never giving up on me and for making me the happiest woman on earth. I love you, always have, always will. I vow to be the best wife, the best friend, and the best mother possible. As life continues to throw us challenges, I promise to love you through the storm and to always search for the light of your heart. You are the love of my life, and I will honor and cherish you forever. I love you.
How do I follow that? That's ridiculous.
Oh my God.
Well, mine's not. Mine's kind of.
It's okay.
Babe.
You tell me.
When you told me, that you wanted to write our vows, I mean, I thought it was so special, but it also brought like some anxiety and nervousness. And I want you to know, every night I would sneak out of the room, go into the living room, drink a couple of glasses of scotch, put on the headphones, and I would start to write. But this speech that I wrote this morning doesn't even apply. I've loved you from the moment I laid eyes on you. That first night I knew I wanted to marry you. And 5 years later, with our beautiful daughter, I love you more today than I did that first night. I can't wait to start this journey together, and I'll always be there for you, no matter what. I loved you then, I love you now, and I love you forever.
Love you too.
Which way?
Two. Three.
Oh my God. Look at her. This is stunning. You look gorgeous. Oh my God, baby.
Thank you.
Wow, you look unbelievable.
Thank you.
This is why I fell in love with her. Look at her.
You look
oh my God. Gorgeous.
Mom's ring.
You got my mom's ring.
And her ring.
Oh my God.
Everybody's your mom's.
A lump in my throat. God. You look gorgeous.
You look
holy
so great too, babe.
Shit.
You look so handsome.
Oh my god.
You look so handsome. Thank you.
Okay.
You like my dress?
Wow.
Is it flashy enough for you? I have the, every dress I tried on.
It's beautiful.
Is it enough for him? Is it enough for him?
You look stunning. Stunning.
Can I take it to a moment where the fields are plain and gold?
Hey, there. You want to go to there? Which one? Only the pencil is good. Yeah.
That presents this woman in marriage this evening. Thank you, folks. You may all be seated. This couple, all those that are standing here with us this evening, we welcome you to this wonderful celebration, and indeed it is. Marriage is always cause for celebration, and before we go forward, I want to do two things. Number one, I want to thank you guys truly from the bottom of my heart. I'm honored and humbled to be here. I don't take lightly that you guys would trust me with even just this small part of, I know, arguably one of the most important days of your lives. And I also want to congratulate you as well. I wish you guys all the happiness and the success and the joy and the peace that you deserve in your life together from this day forward. Mike and Sheila have invited all of you here this evening to witness and celebrate this public declaration of a commitment they've already made in their hearts one to another. So here we are to give recognition to the beauty and the worth of love, to add our best thoughts and prayers and wishes that will unite the two of them in marriage this day. Good Lord. Now, theirs is a partnership that's freely chosen. It's founded on friendship and trust and patience. It's a relationship that encourages an enthusiasm for living. I know this couple believes they function better together as a team. And I know many of you have played a part, large or small, in bringing them to this moment in time, and in various ways may be called upon in the future to contribute to this relationship. Your love and encouragement will forever be appreciated, and I know they truly thank you for being a part of one of life's most special moments. And may you be as an important part of their tomorrows as you obviously are of their today. Now, marriage itself, it's a bold step to be taken together into an unknown future. It's risking who we are for the sake of who we can become. But only when we give ourselves fully to one another does that process of growth begin to take place. So Mike and Sheila stand here today. They come together to declare their love and to be united in marriage. You know, always and appropriately so at every wedding, regardless of stories told, memories shared, young or old, there's one theme that's woven through the tapestry of a wedding day, of a ceremony like this. And that theme might sound a little bit cliche, but it's just love. Love in and of itself is the most powerful force in the universe. There's nothing stronger. You know, it's love that first drew you guys together. Love was working things out before you guys even met one another. Love had a plan all along. You know, I'm always amazed that if, when we are able to manage to exercise even just a little bit of patience in life, take a step or two back, let love have its way, when we do, we get to see some amazing things happen. And we're all witnessing one of these amazing things today. It's that love that drew you together. It's that love that has you standing here right now. And it's going to be that love that holds you guys together as you leave this place today, now no longer as fiancé, but now as husband and wife. It's got a nice ring to it, doesn't it? You know, you think of all these months of planning. When you talk about friends and family to one another, you use that word fiancé. But now that changes today. And when it does, it changes forever, and it's a good change. Except now we're saying things a little bit differently. You know, you're saying things like, you know, let me check with my husband. And you're saying things like, let me ask my wife. You know, you'll be saying that a lot, trust me. But that's the beauty of this amazing love that has drawn you guys together. There's a beautiful passage that illustrates the kind of love that it takes to hold a marriage like this together out of 1 Corinthians 13. And it just simply says this: if I gave everything I have to the poor, I could boast about it, I could even sacrifice my body. But if I don't have love, then I'm of no value whatsoever. Now it describes the kind of love that it takes to hold a union like this together. It says love is patient, love is kind, it's not jealous or boastful, it's not proud or rude. Love never demands its own way, it's not irritable, and it keeps no record of when it's been wronged. Love is always never glad about injustice, but always rejoices whenever the truth wins out. Then it says love never gives up, love never loses faith. It's always hopeful, it endures every circumstance, and then the last three words are the most powerful: love never fails. And that, my friends, is a promise you guys can build your relationship on. Love never fails. Now, the kind of love that's being described here in this passage, the kind of love that goes a little bit deeper than the way we may all understand that word love, or even how we use that word love, but what's the type of love being described here is what's called unconditional love. And unconditional love, at its very root, really demands selflessness. It doesn't suggest it. It doesn't think it's a good idea. It's really a necessity for a marriage. It's going into this relationship with the attitude and the heart set and the mindset of not what can I get from you, but what can I give? What can I contribute every single day to make our lives together better, to make our marriage stronger? It's the kind of love you got to put into practice. You make a decision every day to choose to love one another. It's waking up every morning thinking and saying, I choose to love you no matter what. I choose to love you in spite of, through the good and the bad, the thick and the thin, when the storms of life are blowing and when they're not blowing, you choose to love one another. Mari Nichols wrote some powerful words on marriage. She said, because to the depths of me, I long to love one person with all my heart, my soul, my mind, and my body. Because I need a forever friend to trust with the intimacies of me, who won't hold them against me, who'll love me unconditionally, who sees the small child in me, but yet looks for the divine potential in me. Because marriage means opportunity to grow in love and in friendship, knowing this, I promise myself to take full responsibility for my marriage. For together with God, we create this union, and with this understanding, the possibilities are limitless. So I ask you two today, before God and these witnesses, are you guys ready to pledge your lives one to another? Yeah. Sheila, do you take Mike to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have, to hold, in sickness and in health, for better or for worse, until death do you part?
I do.
Then make this profession to him. I, Sheila.
I, Sheila.
Take you, Mike.
To be my husband.
I promise to love and honor you.
I promise to cherish you.
For the rest of my life.
And
from this moment on.
With all of my heart.
And all of my soul.
We shall be one.
Mike, do you take Sheila to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have, to hold, in sickness and in health, for better or for worse, until death do you part?
I do.
Then make this profession to her as well. I, Mike.
Take you, Sheila.
To be my wife.
I promise to love and honor you.
I promise to cherish you.
For the rest of my life.
And from this moment on.
With all of my heart.
And all of my soul. We shall be one. May I have the rings, please?
Oh, God. Shaking.
The rings are always so beautiful. These are no exception.
Whoa, no, don't let go.
Fashioned out of a very precious and strong metal and always fashioned into a circle. And circles are symbolic because they have no beginning and they have no end. They just simply keep going. So these rings, these circles that you guys will wear from this day forward will always serve as reminders, not only to each other, but to anyone else that you come in contact with from this day forward, that you do indeed belong one to another. So the never-ending circles represent the never-ending love of God. Most importantly, the never-ending love that the two of you have one for another. It's a circle of love that can never be broken. Sheila, I ask you to place that on his finger. And as you do, repeat after me. With this ring, I give you my heart. It is a symbol.
Of
my never-ending love. And I pledge it to you today. I could put that on her finger. And as you do, repeat after me as well. With this ring, I give you my heart. It is a symbol.
Of
my never-ending love. And I pledge it to you today. At this time, we'll have the sand blending ceremony, so we get you guys with the kids. Sheila and Mike, you've just sealed your relationship by the exchanging of vows and the giving and receiving of rings. The union's further symbolized by the combining of these individual containers of sand. One represents you, Sheila, and all that you are, all that you were, and all that you ever will be. And the other one represents you, and all that you were, all that you are, and all that you ever will be as well. The remaining glasses of sand represents each of the children, Michael, Isabella, and Olivia, and all of their unique strengths and characteristics that they bring to the family. Now, each of the sands are unique. They can remain in their own glasses and without ever having the need of being blended. However, when they are combined, it's at that point they form an entirely new and extraordinarily more intricate entity. So at this time, you can now each combine your individual sands into the common glass.
One at a time.
The single glass represents your new life together, and although you're two separate people, your lives are now entwined as one. And just as these sands can never again be separated and poured into individual glasses, so is your marriage and family now, a molding of two personalities forming one heart, one love, one mind, and one spirit. And the life that each of you have experienced up till now individually will hereafter be inseparably united. For truly now, the two have become one, and all have become a family.
Of you. That's beautiful. I'm so proud of you. Bella, I love you, sweetheart. I'm so proud of you.
Right here, Bella. All right.
That's hers. Where's his? Where you're going to stand.
Gotta get a little volume here. Oh, here we go. Where scriptures tell us now, no longer two but one. And what God has joined together, let no man separate. So by the power vested in me, by the state of California, I'm thrilled to be able to pronounce you guys husband and wife. Kiss your bride.
Yeah. Oh my God. Hey.
Well, friends and family, it's my honor to be the first to introduce to all of you this evening Mr. and Mrs. Michael and Sheila Saluzzi. Give them a hand.
Moving forward, using all my breath. Making love to you was never second best. I saw the world crashing all around your face. Never really knowing it was always.
Oh, wow! We did.
Oh my but god. You're...
Next up, we have Lorenzo and Santino. All right, next up, we have Mikey, Isabella, and Olivia. Next we have Roseanne and Patricia. Next up, we have Louisa and Joseph. Louisa and Joseph. All right, now we have Tiffany and Matthew. Tiffany and Matthew. Next up, we have Crystal and Anthony. Crystal and Anthony. Next up, we have Paul and Lacey. Michelle with Isaiah the ring bearer. Maid of honor, Carmel, and the best man, Jerry. Now I'm going to have you guys to the dance floor for their very first dance.
Yeah.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. I think everyone in the room, I think I know just about everyone, at least I've met you tonight. But anyway, my name is Jerry Dehovic. I'm Roseanne's husband, sister to the groom, which makes me Mike's brother-in-law. I am honored to stand in front of you as Mike's best man tonight because, as you know, he has his son, he has his three brothers here, numerous other friends, which could have stood up as his best man. And I know when Mikey and I talked about it, he said, you know, every one of those guys, my son, are my best man, but I'd like you to come up and speak on our behalf and do the ceremonial toast. I said, my pleasure. So all you guys, just so you know, your brother said he considers every one of you his best man. Yeah. That's what he said, except Paulie. Not Paulie, but that's okay. So you might be wondering why I'm looking at this iPad. I have to tell you, I've been a little bit busy at work. And I started drafting my best man speech and got tied up yesterday, had a tire issue coming down, missed the rehearsal dinner, missed a whole bunch of stuff. So, you know, I had to go get new tires this morning, believe it or not. While you all were lounging, I was buying tires. So anyway, I was scrambling a little bit and I had to go, so I said, let me go online and see what they have. They said they have best man speeches for all occasions, sure to be a crowd pleaser. I said, I'm in, so here we go. Let's see what this is all. No, I'm just kidding, of course. A small attempt at humor there. But I'd like to begin by congratulating Mike and Sheila, and let's give this beautiful couple another round of applause. She looks very beautiful. Mike, you look pretty handsome. And for those of you that know Mikey very well, you wouldn't be surprised to know that Mike took twice as long to get dressed and ready today than Sheila did. And that was just his hair, so. But you look good, Mikey. And Shirley, as you know, and I call her Shirley, okay? This everyone says, why the hell do you call her Shirley? Her name is Sheila. Everybody calls her Shirley in our house, and she rolls with it. And that's a nickname of love, and it all started with my mother, forgot her name and kept calling her Shirley. So everybody calls her Shirley. And it stuck. So to my new, beautiful sister-in-law, Sheila Shirley, you look absolutely gorgeous. And let's give the bride a round of applause, too, please. So, when I think of Mike and Shirley, I have to smile because you talk about happy couples and really, honestly, truly, honest to God, that's what I see whenever they're together. It is true happiness between the two of them. They're at our house a lot, and we sit outside and we yuck it up and have a great time, and they are really, really mad about each other. And it's always said that, you know, you should marry your best friend and someone who makes you laugh. And that will lead to many years of wedded bliss. And I can say from all of my observations that clearly Mike and Shirley are each other's best friends. And they sure as heck make each other laugh, especially after a cocktail or two.
That's right.
You've seen it. You all know what I'm talking about. It really does warm my heart to see your interactions together. And, you know, it's babe this and babe that and babe, babe, babe. And I finally have to start answering to Mike when he says babe. I'm like, yeah, what is it, Mike? That's true, right, Mike? No, but they truly love each other, and they've decided to spend their life together, and we couldn't be happier for them. Now, that's not to say that things are always easy and are not always going to be easy. As many of you know, and I hate to say this, but Shirley is a little on the messy side. Okay? She rarely cleans up after herself. Especially in the kitchen. She spills coffee all over the damn place. Bites her nails and spits them on the floor. Lets the trash overflow, stuffs more in so it falls on the floor, leaves clothes all over the place, especially on the floor, and God forbid you go into the bathroom after she's been in there. For those of you who have actually done that, you know what I'm talking about, and you've lived the nightmare. And as you know, this is another attempt at a joke. I'm not talking about Shirley. I'm talking about Mikey! So you can make that list there. All I gotta say though, Shirley, my beautiful sister-in-law, you really must love him, because that was just a short little list there. You know? You've got a lot of fun in store for you over the years, and our hearts go out to you on that. So. But seriously, when I think of Mikey, the word gregarious comes to mind. The word loud also comes to mind. And I think the two go hand in hand, and he really is one of those personalities that stands out in a room when you're sitting there talking. The other thing that comes to mind is how wonderful he is with the kids. And rest assured, he makes a point to ask every one of them, aren't I your favorite uncle? Uncle Mikey's your favorite uncle, right? But the kids don't need to be reminded. You really think about if they're playing monsters, rolling around in the grass, dancing, going to get flogered or froyo or whatever they call it these days, just being silly. It's really a special gift he has with his kids, especially his beloved children and all of his nieces and nephews. I think they'll all attest to that. Mike is an awesome dad and uncle, and it's very heartwarming to see. I also want to note that Mike is the consummate salesman. Mike can sell just about anything to anybody. That's a special gift, and it's brought him really much success in business and your personal life also. In order to be a good salesman, many say you have to be a good, plug your ears, ladies, you have to be a good bullshitter. Mike is the king of BS. The king. He is the best. He can tell a story, he can tell a joke, he can sell ice cubes to an Eskimo. And I say that obviously with utmost love and respect here. It's served you well over the years. Now, Shirley, you know, ever since you've come around, I've always noted and told everyone what a wonderful girl this person is and how lucky is Mike to have you in his life. You really are, 99% of the time. You know, they have a young and the baby, and when she has zero sleep, Shirley's not quite that warm, loving person, okay? But we understand that the lack of sleep has a little bit of an impact on her. But I can tell you the entire family is thrilled to have you officially join as one of us. You are now one of you. Ever seen that movie, The Firm, with Tom Cruise? Everyone knows what I'm talking about. Once you're in, you can never get out. So good luck to you. And I want to say, too, I want to caution you, Shirley, too, if you're looking at for Mike to be your hero in shining armor, and to rescue you in harm's way, you might want to think twice about that. A couple of short stories about my heroic brother-in-law, Mike. There was a time in New Jersey at the beginning of summer when all the big bugs start coming out. All you East Coasters know what I'm talking about. The cicadas, big things flying around, they hit you in the head, knock you over. They make a lot of noise. And anyway, one day we were barbecuing and Mike was on the deck. And Roe and I were inside with my mother-in-law, and there was a big swarm. All of a sudden, I guess it was Mike's cologne, they got all around him, and they were attracted to him, and they started bouncing off his head. And Roe and I, sensing and seeing he was in distress, we did what any good sister and brother-in-law would do. We locked the door and left him outside. And Mike's saying, come on, let me in, come on. You know, that's Mike's word, come on. That's it. And my mother-in-law is in the background screaming, let my son in. Anyway, Roe and I were on the floor laughing, and we left him outside. There was another funny time in New Jersey. And we kind of have a sick thing amongst the family here that we like to scare each other. You know, if there's a shower curtain in the bathroom, someone might be in the tub, someone goes in to use the restroom, and someone will spring out at you. One time we had a power outage, and Mikey was sleeping over on the second story, and there were no lights, and he said, I'm going to go to bed, can't watch TV, et cetera, et cetera. So Ro and I had an idea. Let's get the ladder. We grabbed the ladder, set it up to the second story window. I shimmied up the ladder. I was much bigger back then, but I did shimmy. And the lights were out. I grabbed the flashlight, and I stuck my face in the window and started pounding on the window with the flashlight in my face, screaming. You want to see someone jump out of bed so fast, start scrambling down the hallway, screaming, literally. And you know, that was a pretty horrific sight. It was even more horrific because he was sleeping au naturel that night. So that was kind of scary in and of itself. But, and the most recent show of bravery was when my sister Angie and I and Mike came to my house. I don't know where we came from, but we all happened to arrive at the same time. And we saw something black in the corner. And it looked like a kid's toy. It looked like a big fake spider. And Mike went over and looked at it and said, what the hell is that? Looked at it. This thing started moving and literally jumping a foot off the ground. It was a big black tarantula inside the steps of my house. We just had a neighbor who moved from China, and I guess this thing was on a long boat from China, but it somehow worked its way through my garage. But as you might imagine, Mike saw this spider, screamed, and ran for the front door. Angie and I are like, all right, what are we? We got a broom and we took care of it, and unfortunately the spider didn't make it. But Mikey held true to form. So Shirley, I would just advise you, you know, you might want to start thinking about self-defense classes and maybe springing into action before, you know, all hell breaks loose. But anyway, I mentioned my mother-in-law several times earlier. My mother-in-law was a wonderful, wonderful woman with nothing but love for her family. Family was the most important thing, of course, except next to a good Italian dinner, okay? I'm just kidding. No, family was the most important thing to her. And Mikey, I don't need to remind you, but I'm going to anyway. Your mother loved you, along with all your brothers and your sisters, more than life itself. But you were a special one. For whatever reason, you seemed to get away with murder, and you could do no wrong in her eyes. She was your biggest defender, next to JoJo. JoJo was right up there too, but trust me, Mikey may have gotten a slap here and there, but all the stuff he did, he got away with murder. So, anyway, she was your biggest defender and was so very proud of all of your accomplishments. And she loved you more than words can say, and she's looking down on you and Shirley right now with a big smile. That's especially true when she reaches down and embraces beautiful Bella, Mikey, and Olivia. So, I'm gonna test your memory real quick. I said earlier that Mike was my brother-in-law. And really, we call each other, I'm a brother from a different mother. But one of the things that has always stuck with me and touched me, whenever Mike refers to me, he always says, this is my brother. He doesn't say this is my brother-in-law. Whenever I introduce myself as his brother-in-law, he always corrects me and says, come on, dog, you're my brother, followed up with a big hug and a kiss. That does not go unnoticed, and I am forever moved by that. We've been through a lot together, good and bad, more good than bad. But I, along with the rest of the family, look forward to many decades of family fun and good memories. So with that, they say that an inferno is started by a simple spark. And that little simple spark between the two of you turned into a burning love. Sounds like a good song, Burning Love. But anyway, let's all raise our glasses and toast Mike and Shirley. We love you both very much. We wish you all the best that life has to offer. Salute and jindan. Now there's some other family members that would also like to speak. The oldest brother wants to go first.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, Arrow.
I want to thank you guys for coming down here for this beautiful occasion. And first, I'd like to address Shirley. And I just want to say that I'm so grateful that you entered Mikey's life. And I didn't know the story until after you guys were together for a few years, when he was bringing you down to the house. And Shirley was under the, she didn't know a few things about Mikey. So they drove an hour, and then he pulled over, and then he told her some things, and she came over, and she was like a champ. She handled it like a champ. But anyway, I love you so much, and we're so happy that the Penn and Saluzzi families are together. And you know, I was watching videos of my mother. There aren't that many. I don't know where all the cassettes were, you know, but I was watching, and in so many of the videos she kept saying that God blessed her so much with her children. And I feel that same way, that God blessed us. God blessed me so much, not only with my brothers, but my sisters, you and Crystal and La and Angie and Jackie and Carla. But thank you so much. We love you, and thank you so much for answering that. And you look gorgeous. Okay, now, Antoinette is my name for Olivia, because Olivia just doesn't sound Italian. And I think through the last year and a half, it got confused. Mikey was the name. Mikey was the first one to say, "Oh, we're gonna call her Antoinette if it's a girl." So it came from Mikey, and it just stuck. Anyway, about one of my baby brothers, Mikey. Like Jerry said, he's always been such a charismatic person ever since he was younger. I'm going to try to keep this short because I tend to go on and on. Mikey, there's not a family that I know that hasn't been through ups and downs, and we've certainly had our share, and I could not be more proud of you. I get very uncomfortable when you boys, you know, refer to me like mommy, because mommy certainly had much more patience with you crazy people than I do. She was much softer than I am. The only thing I think we share is the colorful vocabulary. But I have to say, I know that Mommy and Daddy would be so incredibly proud of not only your highs, but your lows, because you fought your way through so many obstacles, and you are such a beautiful, beautiful person. And I love you, and I am so grateful for my Mikey, my baby Mikey, my gorgeous Bella, and my beautiful Antoinette. And I just wish you all the happiness in the world. And I'm so grateful that my girls have you boys, your laughter, your joy of life. I love you.
Michael, come up here. Let's go. He's a Kansas City transplant. He likes this bowl. And he brought the wind with him, too. He said, we're going to have a wedding. I'm going to bring the wind. Are you ready? Everybody get comfy. I'm going to make this short. I want to thank you. You were great today. I just wish nothing. I want to thank you guys for coming here. I want to thank you, this family. Thank you guys. Thanks for bringing a rinse out lives. The baby's incredible. I get to see Bella, Mikey. But I want to thank my brother for just being him his whole life and keeping it short and sweet. I love you guys. Thank you.
All right.
Wow.
All right, everyone. This will just be a moment. Let me clock. Wait, okay. Half hour. No.
I'm sorry, everyone.
You know, in life, as you get older, you hit certain seminal moments, and you reflect back at a union such as this, and you think of the two people here. And I just want to tell you one story of what she's coming into with her husband. No, this isn't a comedy. This is absolute a brother fighting for another brother. We're working on Wall Street. We have a huge brokerage house right next to us. 90 brokers on the floor. And I'm smoking 4 cigars a day. It's back in the time you can smoke in the office. Short broker comes into our office, looks at Mikey, and he ran these 90 people and goes, you know, I'm a little pissed off. Your brother's smoking so much. Mikey looks at him like, are you effing kidding me? He goes, your brother's filling up the whole place with smoke. And meanwhile, these guys are doing whatever they're doing as brokers on Wall Street. And my brother goes for 10 minutes and lays into this guy. I'm not there. I heard, F you, F this, get the F out of my office. I come in later that day, and that whole brokerage house is kissing my ass. Hey, how you doing? How you doing? What's going on? And I hear the story. And so when I look at these two coming together, Sheila, you are getting a huge fighter in this marriage, a man who's going to get your back no matter what. And we've seen it personally through experience. And I want to say I love my brother. This union is fantastic. Just look at that kid right there. It's already a success. And I know as a wife, Sheila's going to have a husband. May not be perfect, but I'll tell you what, if someone goes after her, they're going to think twice. Thank you very much.
Hello, my name is Matt. I've known Sheila for the better part of 20 years. She's an amazing woman, mother, friend, to others. And over the past few years, I've gotten to know Mike. And you'd be hard-pressed to find a more genuine, loving, compassionate person. Excuse me. And I've had the privilege of being able to call him one of my dearest friends. I just want to say that I'm so happy for you guys, and I'm honored to be part of your guys' journey through life together. And I love you guys so much. Congratulations. Is everybody comfortable? All right, let's hear it again for the bride and how beautiful she looked. So I promised I would keep this short and sweet since the best man at our wedding spoke for 90 minutes straight.
from dinner, dessert, past the dance party, the whole nine. He thanked everyone in the room like he was winning an Oscar. We literally watched the video after the wedding, and we got married on Lake Tahoe. Beautiful window in the background, and you can see the sun setting behind JoJo giving his speech. And that's a true story. So this is the dumbed-down version. Mikey told me earlier today he made me promise to give the G-rated version. I know he has some co-workers here, so this is the G-rated version. Those of you that know Mikey well know that he's always been a very modest person. He very rarely talks about himself, his good looks, or any of his own accolades. It's just not in his nature. So he never really mentions all he did for the rest of us, including me, when we were younger. I'm being very sarcastic. So I wanted to take this opportunity to thank him for all he's really done. Growing up, I was the youngest sibling in a single mother household, so often I sought guidance from my older siblings. And he introduced me to so many new things throughout my childhood. He gave me my first Marlboro when I was 7, Heineken when I was 9, Jack Daniels at 10, and everything else when I was 13. You guys can use your imagination. He introduced me to sports, music, Run DMC, AC/DC, songs like Raising Hell, Hell's Bells, Highway to Hell. You guys see a common theme here? All kidding aside, Mike, you were always there for all of us, your family. And through all the ups and downs, you've always had an unwavering love for family, for all of us, and we're all lucky to have you as a part of our family. You were always an inspiration to me, and you still are, and I'm proud to call you my big bro. Sheila, we couldn't be happier to have you as a part of our family. And I couldn't be more proud to be the godfather of Olivia. And we all love you both, and congratulations.
I don't have a speech. I would just like to tell a story about what happened with my dad and my other uncle Matthew. So they were driving one time, and they looked out the window, and then all of a sudden a grasshopper flew in, and my dad screamed higher than a little girl, and almost crashed the car. It eventually flew out, and they continued to drive.
Sheila's sister, Carmel.
Hey, everyone. So, my mom and I were sitting in the bathroom yesterday, doing our hair, whatever, and I said I wrote something, but it's really hard to summarize, like, a whole life with my sister in, like, a second. We have all the memories and everything. This is like really, really difficult. So anyways, I'm big sissy to her and to Caramel, to Mikey on Caramel.
Yeah, Caramel.
That's my nickname. So I want to keep this brief, but if you're just getting to know my sister or if you have known her for years, I want to share with all of you how special she is. So when we were little, Sheila always looked up to me. She used to watch my dance classes from the doorway of the dance studio and mimic all of my dance moves. She knew all the moves by heart. She wanted to be just like Big Sis. So, fast forward 15 years later, and many of you might already know that my sister lived with my grandmother, my mom, and my Aunt Pammy. My mother asked her to move back home when my grandfather passed away. She was in her 20s. While many people living in their 20s were out partying, finding themselves, living the good life, my sister might have done some of those things. Don't fool yourself with that one. but she always found her way home, giving my Grammy little neck massages at night, or helping my Grammy lift Pammy up and down off the floor, adjusting her in her wheelchair, running errands, or making Pammy as comfortable as possible, and not leaving her bedside when she crossed over. My little sis became someone I looked up to. My sister became my best friend. She is the most loyal. She has such a beautiful heart and soul. She's unselfish. She gives amazing warm hugs and snuggles. She has a crazy sense of humor. And most of all, she sees, always sees, the best in people and treats them with kindness that is rare to find. We talk about this all the time. My grandmother instilled this in us, that you always have to find the good in others. One of the things I admire most about her and Mikey is how you always make each other laugh.
Always.
There will be many joys and challenges, but if you can always remember to laugh, I know you guys can get through anything. Mikey, you've been amazing. I know that you will love Sheila for eternity. I know that you will always love and cherish each other. I love the both of you and wish you happiness always. Love your big sis.
I love you.
All right. Round of applause.
So I agree with Mikey. Is it caramel or caramel? There it is.
Caramel.
Show of hands.
We have one more and that's it.
Oh, we got one more? All right. Here we go.
One more.
Here we go, my dear.
So, I am Tiffany. I have been Sheila's best friend for over 20 years. And I'm going to see her today. So beautiful. I'm going to see her with such a man who loves her dearly. And just, Mikey, I love you. I do. Special man, and she's a special woman, and you guys are just beautiful together. And I love you. I didn't have anything planned because I'm a wreck. I would not have been able to read a speech for anything. But today is memorable. This is a beautiful day. This is a beautiful wedding, and this is a beautiful couple. And I wish you guys nothing but all the happiness in the world.
We're gonna get this one.
Perfect. You guys kiss.